In order to change the mode on your camera for your Canon EOS R3, you need to press that little button and then turn that wheel and you choose the mode that you want. The P mode is automatic. When you're using this mode, your camera automatically sets the aperture and the shutter speed for you. When you go to shutter priority mode, which is called TV mode, in this mode, you set the shutter speed and the camera sets the aperture. You're pretty much controlling your motion. And so if you want to freeze the action, you'll move it to 1/1000. And if you want to blur the action, you will want to go to 30 or even use bulb. If you use the AV mode, which is aperture priority mode, you set the aperture, so you decide if you want depth of field or not in your picture, and then your camera will adjust the shutter speed. M is for manual camera mode, and when you're using this mode, you choose all the camera settings. I like to put my camera on manual. I like to put the aperture on 4. I like to put the shutter speed on 1/1 to 5, and I like to leave the ISO on automatic. And the ISO is really going to determine the light, but it's also going to become very, very noisy as it increases. So the idea is to keep the ISO pretty low, but to have everything aligned so you have a good exposure. And I like to use the automatic white balance. This is pretty much how I set up my camera. In order to have a good exposure, you need to work on the shutter speed, the aperture, the ISO, and the white balance. I hope you're enjoying your camera. Please take a second to like this video. Leave me a comment below. Let me know what you think of the camera, what you're having issues with, and if you like this video. So this is how you change your settings from the ISO here, the shutter speed here, and the aperture here. This is really important to know very quickly how you reach them, because when you go on site and take pictures, you don't want to be searching. There are so many buttons, so you need to be comfortable with that. ISO, shutter speed, and aperture. These are the three dials that are accessible to you right here. When you work with the aperture, you're actually working with depth of field, which means, do you want what's behind your subject to be crystal clear, or do you want what's behind your subject to be blurry so that the subject becomes the focal point of your picture? The aperture is the opening of the camera lens, which affects the amount of light that passes through the lens to the sensor. If your aperture is at f-stop 4.0, you have a shallow depth of field and your picture will be brighter because a lot of light comes into your camera. And if your aperture is at f22, you have a deep depth of field. Your image is darker because your lens is closed, almost letting no light enter your camera. When you want to have a large portion of the scene in focus, you need to use a narrow aperture. For landscape photography, you can shoot between f8 and f11. If you want to have a small portion of the scene in focus and you want to blur everything else around, you're shooting in low light, you should have a wide aperture for the maximum opening of your lens. This is very good for portrait or night photography. If you want to change your aperture, you see where it says set here? You're going to turn that dial, and you see now I'm at f25, and if I turn it the other way, I'm at f4.0. When you set your shutter speed, you're actually working with motion. If you're taking pictures of something moving, like a speeding car, like if you're taking pictures of a highway, if you have a shutter speed of 30, you'll have a longer exposure and you'll have blur action. If, however, you have a shutter speed of 1/1000, you have a shorter exposure, and so the action will be frozen. When you want to capture motion, like a long exposure photography, or you want to shoot in low light, like a night photography, you should use a slower shutter speed. So you'll be between 1/60th of a second up to a second. If you want to freeze motion, then you need to use a faster shutter speed, between 1/60th and the minimum shutter speed setting in your camera. This is very good for action shots, wildlife, sports photography, a speeding car, people running, a highway, things of that nature. If you want to change your shutter speed, you go in front of the camera here, and there is a little dial here. This one changes your shutter speed, and not the ISO. This is a key setting on a camera. The ISO affects the exposure and the noise. If your ISO is too high, your picture will be ruined because it will all be noisy. The cameras lately are much, much better. You can now have much higher ISO and have very good quality pictures, but you still have to be careful. You try to bring your ISO down. The ISO is measured in ISO levels. It follows a sequence of numbers. The higher the ISO, the higher the amount of light, and the higher the amount of noise. In the Canon EOS R3, you change the ISO by the wheel that is right around the mode. You use that wheel to change your ISO. Okay, so that's a lot to digest, but at least hopefully I'll have given you a little clarity on the different camera modes that you have and the settings that you have available on the Canon EOS R3. Make sure you take a second to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want more videos like this one, and hopefully I'll see you around. Have a beautiful day.